It's a Big 8 SEC doubleheader. Welcome, everybody. I'm Chris Fowler. First game, Kansas and Kansas State, the battle of the Sunflower State. K-State has lost 7 in a row to the Jayhawks in Manhattan. They are desperate to end that humiliation. Kansas, 13-4, very good at home, not so good on the road. Every Big 8 team has struggled on the road, it seems, this year, except for Nebraska. Game 2, we go to the SEC. Kentucky, Rick Pitino's team, the surprise team in the conference. Be prepared for a lot of three-pointers to be launched in this ball game. That's at 9:30 from Auburn. Coming up at halftime, we will have, as usual, scores, as well as a look at the history of hoops. Before Dr. J, there was Dr. James Naismith, although the history of hoops may go farther back than that. We'll have some rare video of basketball's original big man coming up at halftime. But after this break, it's out to Manhattan, Kansas. John Saunders and Larry Conley, Kansas against Kansas State. Enjoy the first half. We'll see you at intermission.
Bramlage Coliseum on the campus of Kansas State University, where tonight ESPN presents the Big 8, the 24th-ranked Jayhawks of Kansas and the Kansas State Wildcats. Hello once again, everyone. I'm John Saunders along with Larry Conley, and welcome here to what is a great matchup, very storied. 220th meeting, although lately, Larry, it's belonged to the Kansas Jayhawks. Roy Williams has a very well-oiled machine.
John, he does, and one of the reasons they're number two in the nation in field goal percentage is because they pass the ball so well. They distribute it well. They move the ball well. As an example, take a look at the way they move it in this particular play. Watch Maddox get the good position inside, a ball pass away from the defense. Now watch again how they reverse it. Adonis Jordan picking it up. Good bounce pass to Mark Randall with a strong move to the glass. It's the one thing Kansas does so very well, pass it and distribute it.
Yeah, they also have a guy who hits the three-point shots like nobody else. Terry Brown is tremendous. You look at Mark Randall's numbers, but Terry Brown has 73-point shots already this year. 21 more, and he will reach Mookie Blaylock for the single-season record. So Kansas State will have to defend him, although K-State does a good job defensively.
Well, they do, and they were the number six team in the nation in field goal percentage defense until the last two games. But he got a great shot blocker down on the inside, a guy who happens to be the brother of Stacey King, Darryl King. He really is a fine shot blocker. He needs to expand his game a little bit here tonight against a very talented Kansas club.
Offensively, they look to Gene Delaware, although Delaware has struggled the last couple of games.
Well, he has. He's 5 of 26 in the last two games, a guy that they really need desperately to have a good game. He's really struggled because I think he's pressing. He's trying to assume a leadership role. Sometimes you got to just let the game come to you.
All right, one of the greatest rivalries in all of college basketball. We'll be back in just a moment with the starting lineups, Kansas and Kansas State.
ESPN's presentation of NCAA basketball, Kansas versus Kansas State, is brought to you by Mercedes-Benz, engineered like no other car in the world, and by Campbell's Chunky Soup, the satisfying stop that keeps you going.
Welcome back once again, everyone, to Manhattan, Kansas. John Saunders along with Larry Conley. Kansas State and Kansas just about to tip it off. Let's take a look at Roy Williams, former assistant under Dean Smith in his third year at Kansas. Terrific record at 62-21. They're 13-4 this year. And his starting lineup, Adonis Jordan, the guy who runs the show. Career high 24 points against Missouri this year. Averages over 11 points a game. Meantime, for Kansas State, Jeff Wires is the guy at guard running the ball, and he has a terrific lineup to work with. Perhaps maybe even better athletes than the Kansas team, but that remains to be seen. And of course, the man who's a coach in his first year is Dana Altman. Came from Southern Conference last year at Marshall, where he was the co-coach of the year in the Southern Conference. His first year is at 10-7. Larry Conley, what do you look for in this one?
Well, in this game, John, you got a couple of things. One for Kansas, they've got to create turnovers off their press. They're very good with it. The three-point shooting of Brown goes unquestioned. Kansas State, a smaller lineup tonight, a little quicker defensively, but Delaware is the key. He's got to get back on track.
Gene Delaware has been struggling, coming off back-to-back games in single digits, and that's the first time in his career at Kansas State that has ever happened. That's remarkable in itself.
John, they got a great rivalry here. Is this crowd pumped?
I mean, we haven't even tipped it off yet. It's as loud as some games I've seen in the middle of it. They tip it off. Mo Britton knocks it. It goes out of bounds off of Kansas and will belong to K-State.
I'll tell you what, Kansas has owned this series in recent years, but they have played a number of close basketball games. Immediately, Kansas out on top.
Well, that's a great matchup. Jordan against Wires. Two quick point guards. Kansas in a man-to-man. Good pressure.
Driving through the lane with the finger roll, but they'll call the charge. They're going to count the basket, I believe. It was Delaware going to the hole. Haven't seen them wave it off yet. Basket is good.
Watch this move down the middle. Oh, what a great beginning for Gene Delaware, a guy who has been struggling. All of a sudden, first play out of the gate, right down the lane. Yes, the foul, but forget that. He got the basket, and that's what he was looking for. John, I expect Kansas State to really pick Kansas up at midcourt and stay with him. Good man-to-man pressure. Wires as quick as Jordan is.
Watch for the passing of the Jayhawks that Larry talked about in our pregame.
Look at this pressure. K-State is very good at this. They need to step out and assert themselves defensively, and they're doing it right now.
Down onto the baseline. Jordan looking for an opening, pushes it into Randall. The shot is too strong. K-State comes away with an Amerson.
You've ever heard a crowd get excited about a rebound? They just did. I'll tell you what, the adrenaline is flowing. There's about 15,000 in here. They've got them jammed in every seat.
And many of them are still standing in the student section. Baseline shot by Brown is no good. The follow.
Altman wanted a foul. He thought Jameson went right up over the back of his player. Might have been right.
Jayhawks on the board now.
Still the man-to-man defense by Kansas. Kansas State runs a low 1-4. A lot of screening down inside. Good double team by the Jayhawks.
Amerson is double teamed, and the foul is whistled. Maddox holds his hands up as if to say, who, me?
You know, John, the one thing that I'm always impressed with Roy Williams' clubs are the way they trap. You know, there's just the right way and the wrong way to trap. This is a good trap. You find a guy, use the sideline, you've got him in the corner, Brown and Maddox right there, but they commit the foul, and they let him out.
Wires with Adonis Jordan on him, hangs in the air, gets fouled. Roy Williams immediately up off the bench, calling for the offensive foul.
You know what, in the NBA, you get that. The throw, the left-hand throw, Roy Williams right there demonstrating, saying, come on. You think these coaches are intense? They've been off the bench. We haven't played 2 minutes yet.
Kansas State 0-4 in the conference. And that may be one reason why they come out this intense, aside from the fact that they're playing their hated rival.
Well, this is one thing that Kansas State has struggled with this year, shooting free throws. 62% as a team. I bet Kansas, 60%. Neither club really able to do anything at the charity stripe.
If it comes down to that tonight, we could see some excitement down the end.
I don't know what it is, John, but I've seen more teams with poor free throw shooting this year. By the way, nice to have you out of the studio. Glad to get you here.
Nice to be here. Tossed away. That'll be a turnover. Eddie Hightower with the whistle. Randall puts his hand on the ball.
Well, so far it has been Kansas State's basketball game. Watch it again. Good job by Amerson out there handling the basketball. There's the turnover. Backcourt goes to the Jayhawks.
Ball almost thrown away. Delaware with a nice job to keep it in. Amerson hangs in the air and hits the shot.
Those fall for you at home. They'll go in.
Pushing it into Randall, but it's stolen by Britton.
Are you sure this team's 0-4 in this conference?
Hard to believe. Inside the corner.
I couldn't hear you if you were talking right now.
I was. 8-2 start. The Cats. Terry Brown pushes in, leans, does get a nice roll.
Oh, that was a pretty play. Terry Brown right down the lane, avoided the charge. It was a good no call by the officials.
K-State has yet to miss a shot. And Ziegler, that's their first miss in the game. Jameson has the rebound.
This game will settle down in a minute. The adrenaline will quit
flowing the way it has, and these clubs will get down to execution.
Maddox is open. That's not his shot.
Wires is guarding Brown. That's a good matchup. And Ziegler on Jordan. Good isolation. Jameson.
Nice move by Jameson, but he can't get it to fall, and Britton has the board. Is open for a three. No good. Kansas, some confusion, kicking the ball around.
Kansas not taking very good care of the basketball right now. Both KU players reluctant to even bend over and pick it up.
Delaware on the baseline loses the handle, and it goes over top of the backboard. Kansas has turned it over three times already, just about at the 4-minute mark in this game. Richie checks into the game for the Jayhawks.
Yeah, they got Alonzo Jameson out of the game very quickly right there. Roy Williams did. I'm just wondering if something might be wrong with him. He went down pretty hard on the play previously. Both coaches over there. I don't see the trainer talking to him, so I guess he's all right. They got him out of there pretty quickly. Great handle of the basketball. Takes great care of it. Has a 2-to-1 assist to turnover ratio.
Richie leans in, gets fouled before he releases the ball. In the act of shooting, will go to the line.
John, this is a young man that was very heavily recruited by both Missouri and Kentucky. He decided to go to Kansas. I've seen him a couple of times earlier in the year. He's going to be a really fine player for them. He can play a guard or a forward. He's 6'8". A little on the thin side, 190. He's a little more meat on him.
Just a freshman. Plenty of time to bulk up. But again, you talk about the free throw problem for both these teams, and there's an example.
It's almost as if the free throw shooters in America have just disappeared. They've gone into caves.
Misses both of them, but it goes off Kansas State and out of bounds. 15:39 to go. The Cats are up 8-4. Back in a moment. In the Middle East as part of Operation Desert Storm include the 1st Infantry Division of Fort Riley, Kansas. Today, more than 11,000 men and women of the Big Red One are overseas as part of the military forces. And, of course, our thoughts here at ESPN go to the men and women of the National Guard and Reserves who are also there. The yellow ribbons you see attached to the score clock here in Manhattan are, of course, for those men and women fighting Desert Storm.
Out-of-bounds play by Kansas. Kansas State runs a man-to-man defense. Most clubs go to the zone on the out-of-bounds. Bobcats did it. 1-4 alignment by Kansas. Watch the ball movement by the Jayhawks. Touch the screens.
Steve Fritz is into the game for Kansas State, number 30. Falling Maddox. Jordan is open for a three. That's his forte. There's a foul after the shot. Mark Randall banging underneath with number 22, Wiley Howard, and Randall is called for the foul.
I'll tell you what, that one could have gone either way. I'm not sure who had the advantage. Both of them went to the floor. I was giving them a press on that. I think both shoulders were down.
Pressure by Kansas.
It's under all-out pressure, though. I've seen them come out and really get after you. It's just kind of a passive press right now.
Amerson open. The shot hits nothing.
John, the one thing that Dana Altman talked about today, their shooting, how poor it has been. They just do not shoot the ball well, as evidenced by that. An air ball from 12 feet.
Amerson pushes it back out. Again, the miss by Brown. Coming the other way, that'll be called for a travel as he lost the handle on the ball.
Watch Steve Fritz handle the basketball. He's an interesting story. You know what, he might have thought it was a javelin or a shot put.
He's a decathlete, one of the best in the country. Tunstall checking into the game. Sean Tunstall out of St. Louis for the Jayhawks.
You know, Fritz is a walk-on. I mean, he was a walk-on on this club, and he played junior college basketball with Mo Britton. But it's a great decathlete. In fact, he was ranked 9th by the World Track News publication. This guy's a great athlete.
Tom Kent still had the shot and gave it up. Maddox, the shot is too hard. Randall battling in there.
Oh, Randall with a great, great job on the board.
Jeff Dwyer's called for the foul.
Now they're going to change it. They're going to give it, looks like, to Wiley Howard. Yeah, they gave it to Howard on Randall's back. He ran a lot of credit. He went back three times for the ball. Just can't have stayed on this man-to-man over the out-of-bounds play. You love to watch a good passing team. That's what Kansas is. Watch where the ball hits. Always in the hands. Foul on Kansas State down underneath.
I think it was Fritz who got whistled that time as he reached in on Randall. Took the pass and turned towards the hoop. Randall would have wished they didn't blow the whistle on that because he had an easy layup if they didn't.
How many guys do you know in America that are ranked ninth by Track and Field News as a decathlete out here playing basketball? I don't know of any.
The first guy's off the bench, too. Britton back into the game.
The backcourt kept that time by Jordan. Look at Randall open.
Randall following the screen that was tossed by Adonis Jordan.
John, what made that play open was the fact that Jordan made the cut baseline, and once he got down there, once he was not open, Randall came from the other side, and Jordan set the screen, and it popped it open for him on that side. There's Dane Alden, first-year coach here at Kansas State. Was an assistant here for many years under Lon Kruger.
Under Lon Kruger. Went away for that year at Marshall, came back. Rediger checks into the game for K-State. Here's a look at Dana Alden.
This is the third tallest team in Kansas State history. Kansas field goals, 2 of 9. They've had 5 straight misses.
Randall knocks them both down. It's back to a 2-point game.
Now here comes that trap. Midcourt, Randall, Jordan, Tunstall all looking for the trap. Good handle by K-State. Beautiful pass. Keep it in the middle.
Myers pushes it back up to Ziegler for the three. No good. Britton nearly comes down with it, but Maddox comes away for Kansas.
Oh, he took it out of his hands. He took it out of his hands.
Jump ball.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
He stripped it right away. Jeff Myers.
John, I don't think I have ever seen this happen. Watch Jeff Myers go up. Christoph just took it right out of his hands. It was like a defensive back going back against a wide receiver. What a play.
Stripping the ball away was Jeff Myers and getting the jump ball. Possession arrow for Kansas, so they maintain possession, but that gets the crowd going once again.
We got a block. Offensive foul against Kansas. Alonzo Jamison, illegal screen.
I cannot get over that play. I have never seen that in all the years I've been around college basketball, particularly from a guard.
I'll tell you what, when the official first blew the whistle, I think he wanted to call a foul until he realized what had happened. I don't think he could believe it either. That ball will be thrown away.
Great defense by Kansas that time. They really put the pressure on the passer. A lot of people forget about that. You got to be able to guard the guy with the ball.
I was going to say, you used to have better hands than that. That went right over your head.
Somebody grabbed me from behind.
Kansas with a chance to tie or take the lead with a 3-pointer.
Jordan with a good bounce pass. Jamison's open.
They're going to call travel there. Took a couple of steps before he made his move to the basket.
A little walk in the park, right across the lane.
I think you've got to give Kansas State some credit for the defense they're playing right now, not allowing those good passing lanes that you talked about.
Well, I think both of these clubs are playing pretty good defense.
Wires leans in and won't fall, though.
Kansas State cannot get the ball to drop.
5 minutes since their last field goal for the Wildcats.
Good pass.
Jamison with a good fake, but then can't get it to fall. And Wires comes away with it. Delaware has found his stroke at least early.
He's got 3 baskets in the first half. 6 of the 10. A good start.
Jamison, good strong move. Oh, was that a good look by Randall? Mark Randall, one of the better passers from that middle slot. Kansas State doing a good job of handling the press, but they turned it over on a good block by Jamison.
Redinger turned to face the basket, just had it stripped out of his hand.
Kansas is a little bit more patient. Now, Kansas State has kind of backed off on their pressure. They're not coming after them as much as they were early on.
Jordan was open behind the screen and touched it, but gives it up to Maddox. Shot is short. Delaware brings it the other way.
Neither one of these clubs really putting up the type of shots we really wanted or expected to see from them. Defense has been awfully good, though. Good recovery. Everybody staying with their knitting. A bit of a conservative game going on now. A little bit of a chess match.
Wires puts the shot up and hits it down over top of his man, Adonis Jordan.
Kansas again with that good half-court ball movement. Take a look at the inside. Watch the screens down low. Double team opens it up. Good look, good passing. Look at that ball movement. Excellent, excellent. Adonis Jordan baseline. Roy Williams off the bench applauding that. He should. That was a good trip.
2-point game. K-State still on top. They have led since the start.
I'm going to tell you what, we've got an army in front of us waiting to get in this game right here.
We could have a second game right over on the baseline as Delaware misses. Redinger with a big rebound. Delaware will get a second chance at it and misses again.
Wires got it. He took it away from Redinger. Oh, threw it away.
10:02 to go. Kansas and Kansas State, the rivalry, everything we've described thus far. Along with Larry Connolly. And Larry, you alluded to the fact that it was nice to have me here out of the studio. Well, the reason I am here, and Bob Carpenter, your usual Tuesday night partner, is not along with us, is that Bob's mom, Florence, passed away at age 77 this past week, and he's, of course, attending the funeral. And we at ESPN, of course, want to send our best wishes out to Bob and the rest of his family, and, of course, all our sorrows as well.
Bob, our feelings and thoughts are with you, buddy. Hang in there. We know you're watching. Here's a stats flash. Our producer Woody Fryman thought this one up today. I love it. Field goal percentage, turnovers, you get everything quickly. Soon to be, I'm sure, a staple of ESPN, going to be on every game.
That's right. Everyone will pick that up. Steve Woodbury, number 20, is into the game for Kansas. Also, Patrick Ritchie back into the game as well.
Kansas State taking a look. Delaware tried to get inside to Wiley Howard. Good defense by Kansas. Oftentimes when you've got clubs not shooting well, right now Wires not handling the ball well. His turnovers have really hurt Kansas State here in the first half.
Well, he was looking for Redinger to cut away from the paint, and Redinger just stood where he was. The pass just went flying to someone in the first row.
Well, oftentimes, John, when you have this type of game, both clubs are so pumped. And I talked about that adrenaline flow at the beginning of the game. The game needs to get settled down, and both teams need to execute a little bit better. They turned it over a lot, and their field goal percentage shooting has been going down.
Brown with Wires doing a great job on him.
His defense is outstanding.
Kickball, reset the clock. That's not good because K-State had really worked it down as well.
But does it drive you crazy? I mean, you're out there, you're working like crazy for 42 seconds, and then one of your buddies kicks it. It says the set it at 45. You turn and look at it and say, come on.
They're handing into the game, number 54.
Also, Wagner in the game for Kansas, a player that they've missed. He missed six ball games while he was out with that knee injury.
See the knee brace there, and the foul away from the basketball, whistled against the Jayhawks.
It was just Wagner, wasn't it?
Yep, Kirk Wagner. Back handling the basketball for Kansas State, number 5, Marcus Ziegler.
Pretty good coaching move by Dana Alton right there. I think he felt like Jeff Wires was not getting it done out front.
Delaware bangs it down. That's just a 2-pointer. But again, he looks like he's regained his stroke.
Kansas State wants to press. Redeker does, but I don't think anybody wants to join him.
All alone. Richie does most of the work to get it over the timeline.
Kansas State's done a nice job of extending that defense, shutting down the three-point shooting of Kansas tonight.
Turnaround shot is an air ball by Johanning. And the crowd lets him know it.
Tough to break on either one of these clubs. There's the trap again.
Kansas 4 of 14 to this point in the game. 28% they're shooting.
Nice trap. Good look.
Redeker turns around, hangs, and hits it.
Talk about a shot put look team shot. Again, Kansas State steps up. Right now, Delaware's back off of Richie. Everybody else playing tight. Strong post play. Wagner wants to get it in. Richie throws it away.
6-point lead for the Wildcats. 7:33 to go in the first half. Coach Williams wants to talk about it.
Wildcats are up by 6, but it's because Kansas is usually a very proficient team from the field. Second in the nation at 55% in their field goal percentage this year. Look what they're doing tonight. 4 of 14 for 29%. That can't make that man right there very happy, Roy Williams.
Not to mention that, 3 of their starters, Maddox, Randall, and Brown, have a total of 6 shots in the game. So the guys they normally want to shoot the basketball aren't doing it.
John, it's very important. Like, Kansas State's really taking the three-point shooting away from Kansas.
Nice move. Pass to Amerson, though. Redeker feeds him nicely.
It was a nice kick by Ziegler.
Yeah.
I know a guy that could have used it on Sunday.
Buffalo Bills, maybe.
Nice dish inside. Jordan with a great pass. Jamison with a layup. Always make the pass away from the defender. Adonis Jordan got it inside.
And he's with their starters back in there.
Talk about great ball movement. K-State just moved that ball on the perimeter very well.
Delaware's shot was short, but it looked like it mesmerized everyone. They got the rebound. Jamison all alone, jams it down, and was fouled. Not a good foul. I don't think there was any question he was going to get the dunk.
Well, you know, Amerson is at least 2 steps behind him going to the basket. And it's an excellent 2-on-1 break. Give the ball to the guy ahead of you. Now watch the strip. Watch Jamerson come up with a steep strip right here. Good play. Now he looks up. He's got Adonis Jordan on his left. He kicks the ball to the left. Jordan gets it right back to him. He's got the break, jam, and the foul. That's the way you handle it. You got 2-on-1. Give it to the ball to the guy that's ahead of you, and you'll get it back. Yeah, he's having a good first half.
You like him as a player, don't you?
Yeah, I really do. Well, I don't like that shot. I like everything he does for this club. He's just a good role player. You know, he shot more free throws than anybody on this team. That tells you something. The guy is aggressive, he's active, and he wants to get to the basket. Andrews again, good man-to-man. Delaware's left open out top.
Anderson along the baseline. The shot won't fall down.
Power rebound by Jordan. Look at that pass.
Oh, Maddox and Amerson, it looks like, reached and grabbed his hand as he was about to go with the right hand to the glass.
John, when you get the post, most players, once they get in the post, raise their hand when they want the ball. When you see a player raise his hand, that means I'm ready to receive the pass. That time, Maddox got it up. Randall got it to him, and he drew the foul. Here's a man who did not have a very good first couple of minutes in this game. Jeff Wires back in the lineup.
Wires comes in. Fritz also checks back in.
This is a small lineup that Kansas State has in there right now, with Britton, the biggest player, at 6'9". The next biggest player, Steve Fritz, at 6'4".
And again, the free throw problems continue.
And we talked about free throw shooting. Number 7 and number 8.
They don't get any worse than these two teams in the Big 8. They're not going to help the numbers with that. K-State comes away with it. Delaware at the other end. Locked. Shot is blocked. Nice job by Britton to come up with it, though.
I'll say one thing for Delaware. He's not shy. I mean, if he can't get it going, he'll keep trying until he does get it going. He missed a shot right there that was blocked by Maddox, but that didn't deter him. He went right back at it again. Watch the move right here. Here comes Randall. Good pump fake by Delaware.
Got his man in the air and on his back. That's where the foul is committed. Finally, somebody finds something other than the iron on a free throw.
That Roy Williams countering with a small lineup of his own.
Tunstall comes in. Randall will take a seat.
And Jameson's at 6'6". You've got Maddox out there who is at 6'7". Britton's at 6'9", the tallest player on the floor right now. Kansas' biggest player is Maddox at 6'7".
Delaware knocks down his 10th point of the game. And the Cats have a 2014 six-point lead again.
Got a bunch of Mighty Mites out there right now. Good double team.
Stripped nicely by Wires.
He might have got hacked a little bit, John. I thought maybe he got a hit across the arm.
I'll tell you what, Roy Williams thinks he did.
Yeah. Pretty hard to lose the basketball unless some guy's crawling up your elbow.
It is tough to win on the road in the Big 8 this year. Only one team has won on the road, and they've done it twice, and that's Nebraska. Ziegler can't get it to go. Everyone else is winless on the road.
Look at Jordan. Good move, good pass.
Brown for three, off the mark, and Brown hasn't had his three-point shot going. Jordan looks for a seam, crashes in, travels. Rather than call the offensive foul, they whistle a travel there, but I think the crowd would have liked the foul.
Donis had his rockets on right now, blowing down that lane, and he couldn't turn off the retro. Look at this move. Oh, he tripped over Britton's foot right there. That was the reason he traveled. Kansas extending that defense. Brown way out on top.
Bo Britton shooting down at the basket, it looked like.
Strong rebound by Tunstall. Nice move.
Jason, nice move.
I really like him, John. I think he's a good player. He does so much for this club.
He has 10 points in the contest as well. Ball is stolen, but called for the foul is Steve Fritz. That's his third. Coming off the bench, picks up his third.
I think that might have been the one that sends him to the line, 1-1. For these two clubs, that could be a detriment.
We keep sending them to the line for 1-1, and when they get to the 10 shot, two shots, they'll be here for a long time.
This man's done an awfully good job since he arrived at Kansas.
I want to remind everyone, the second half of our doubleheader tonight, Kentucky ranked number 10 in the nation in Auburn in the Southeastern Conference. Rick Pitino's Wildcats just letting them fly the three-pointers. An exciting team to watch.
Pitino's Bombinos.
That's right. Tunstall converts.
I've never seen both clubs tonight get in and really get after the press. Kansas just very passive. They want to play man-to-man. And here's Brown coming out top. A little half-court trap now by Kansas. Kansas State keeps the dribble alive. Very important on a press to keep the dribble alive.
Wires gets up and gets the shot.
Yeah, that little breather might have helped him. Get him over there and get him settled down a little bit.
Yeah, he was struggling with the basketball, but you're right. And having Ziegler handle it makes a difference.
Nina Altman telling his club, get up, get up, body up. And he pushed that body up against the man with the ball. Cut off that first wing pass.
Jordan loses it, has it stripped by Delaware. Wires, nice block by Jordan.
Jordan almost did the same thing to Wires.
Down to Wagner, who lets the little jump hook go.
Nice little touch, you know. A little soft shot.
Two-point game once again.
Pressure again by Kansas. Well, both of these clubs are really playing good defense now.
Amerson hits the baseline jumper.
Got to be smart about your double team. Don't leave a guy open from 15 feet. Wires is all over Terry Brown. I mean, he has not let him breathe tonight. When he inhales, he exhales.
Battling. They're going to whistle a foul against Kansas and Adonis Jordan. That was one that they might have called both players for. They were pushing back and forth.
John, it's the old basketball adage. It's always the guy that retaliates that gets caught. Ziegler and Jordan were going at it, both of them pushing in the chest. And really, it was Jordan who was the one who got caught. Now watch it right here. There's the push. There's another push. I think Ed Hightower just said, that's enough. I saw one. I'm not going to see any more.
Ed Hightower was fortunate to make it to the game today. He's telling us big ice storm in St. Louis. He almost didn't make it here.
I know you're happy to hear about that.
Yeah, got to go back through there to get home.
There's one of the best officials in the country right there, Ed Hightower, refereeing the Final Four a number of times. I think one of the really coolest, the most dispassionate officials, and I think you got to have that. And he's very objective.
Always under control. Doesn't let his emotions get involved when the coaches get all over him, and they will. Jameson checks back into the game. Ziegler tries to make it a 6-point Wildcat lead. He converts it. 26-20 is our score. 3:11 to go in the first half. And this Wildcat, reason to smile. Thanks a lot, Chris Fowler. And we should remind everyone that the inventor of the game of basketball was Canadian. Dr. Naismith from London, Ontario, had to get that in.
Who was the only coach that was a losing coach in Kansas?
Dr. Naismith.
That's correct.
Absolutely. Well, travel by Mark Randall as he was double-teamed nicely. The 11th turnover of the game for Kansas.
Pressure a little bit. Delaware handling pretty easily against Jameson out top. Look at that move down the lane.
Nice roll. Gets the shooter's touch there on the iron.
Well, he needs a good game tonight. His confidence is somewhat eroded by his last two games, but he's picked up the pace here tonight. These two staffs are working hard on the sideline.
Randall turns from, bangs it hard off the glass, and it's good.
You know, John, Mark Randall got a new rebound earlier in this basketball game to put him in some fairly elite company.
That's right. He's in the 1,300-point club along with 600 rebounds. That's just his first 2 points of the game. Danny Manning, Will Chamberlain,
Vlad Lavellet, Dave Robish.
That's quite a group. We'll take a look at the all-time winning percentage for the coaches at Kansas. Larry Brown, who's now in the NBA with San Antonio, and Roy Williams, just in his third season. A tremendous job he's done there. And you see Dr. Naismith. He invented the game, but he didn't perfect it, apparently.
Probably went back to Canada.
Tunstall double team, and the ball is stripped away, and Ziegler comes away with it.
Great trap by the Wildcats.
Nice pass to Amerson. They're going to call an offensive foul.
Amerson with a charge, out of control. There's a hard hat. He hates Kansas. Kansas State handling the basketball. Handled the break well here. It was a good dish by Ziegler. And a good catch by Amerson. But a better defensive play. I don't know. You know, he might have been moving a little bit. Hard to tell from that angle.
Yeah, I was surprised when he called it offensive. Flyers will come back into the game.
John, that was also the 9th team foul for Kansas State in this basketball game, so the 10th one will send them Kansas to the line for 2 the next time the foul is committed.
Randall off the front iron, knocked out nicely by Maddox, and they'll retain possession.
Kansas State's defense has been stunning, absolutely stunning in this first half.
Again, a foul away from the basketball against K-State. Looks like Jeff Wyers.
Wyers got a little bit of a push.
Reminder, don't forget at halftime to join Chris Fowler. Top 25 scores and highlights, a look at basketball's earliest beginning. Chris Fowler will have all of that and more. We'll have rare footage of Dr. Naismith, the man we've talked about so much here. In the first half, former coach of the Kansas Jayhawks and the inventor of the game.
Was the referee a ball boy for Dr. Naismith?
I think he was.
I think he was, too.
I think he was one of the original guys that put it in the peach basket. Kansas now finally reaches the 50% mark in free throws of this game. 6 for 12.
1-3-1, half-court trap by Kansas. They got Jamison on the top. Trap in the corner, trap at the wings. You attack this with a two-guard front. You probe at the wings. That's what Kansas State's doing right now. Hey, you're doing a nice job. Good trap. Take a look. Don't rush into your trap. Be smart about where you go. Good dish by K-State. Look opposite. Yes. Always look opposite. You're going to find somebody open. If the trap comes, somebody's going to be open in the middle.
Redinger down to Wires, who finds Britton, but Britton gets hammered along the baseline, and Mark Randall picks up the foul.
Well, Mo Britton has lost about 20 pounds since he got here. Let's take a look and see if Mark Randall, who commits his third foul, maybe that loss of weight right there was the reason he went down and probably got him a foul.
Mark Randall will have to take a seat with his third. Under a minute here to go in the first half. Mo Britton played for Bobby Kremins at Georgia Tech for a season after coming out of junior college. Came out, transferred to Marshall, sat out the year. Marshall went on probation. When Dana Altman came here to Kansas State, Mo Britton says, I'll come along with you and finish out my career.
I'll tell you what, these guys cannot tie a free throw at the line.
Woodbury trying to do it by himself. Finally dishes it. Jamison can't get it to fall.
Kansas again got the rebound. Now the good ball movement and again the pressure. Look at Wires on Brown. Story of the first half, the way Jeff Wires has played Terry Brown.
Jamison leans in, knocks his man over. Delaware and still gets the hoop.
The second biggest story is the play of that man, Alonzo Jamison.
12 points in the game. Shot clock is off, or it should be. They've left it on, but it should be off.
Listen to the crowd. Count for the Kansas State team. Their home club will let them know.
Wires gets fouled, and Roy Williams is furious. Steve Woodbury over the top, and I don't think he's furious at his player, but at the official.
Well, he did not want that call. Let's take a look. Let's see what he's upset about. Now watch the move right here by Wires down inside. You see Brown right there. I tell you, he got a lot of the ball, an awful lot of ball.
Yeah, that looked like one of those phantom fouls, and I can understand now why Roy Williams was upset.
Let's go back and take a look at it again. Now down low, you can see the shot from here. Oh, that was all ball. That was all ball.
If there was any contact, that came certainly after the block. Wires hits them both. Makes it a four-point lead. 3 seconds left. Kansas will get one last shot. Jamison, I don't think he got it off before the buzzer. No. Officials waving it off. So at halftime, the Wildcats have a 30-26 lead in this, the 220th meeting. Chris Fowler coming up with halftime in just a moment. There's plenty more to come on ESPN.
Might want to be here tomorrow night, one of the best doubleheaders of the year. First place in the ACC at stake when Duke battles Georgia Tech. The Jackets try to come back from that humiliation the last time. And then St. John's, leader in the Big East right now against their old rivals from Georgetown. Games like those two, exactly what Dr. James Naismith had in mind when he invented basketball 100 years ago. You may know all about the old peach basket at the YMCA, but what you may not know is that basketball, as Charlie Steiner reports, has its roots in two other North American countries, 19th century Canada and ancient Mexico.
Basketball, 100 years old this year, is hardly a game worth losing your head over, but a cousin long removed. A game played by the Maya in Mexico with the Earth's first rubber ball, an elevated hoop in great stadiums, brought real meaning to the term sudden death.
In the end of this ball game, the defeated parties would be sacrificed.
The Maya thrived during the time when Nero fiddled with fire and Robin Hood diddled with Maid Marian. Dr. Robert Scherer spent most of his adult life studying the Maya.
The earliest ball games go back to the first, that we have evidence of, go back to the first millennium, the first 1,000 years B.C., during our Middle Ages in equivalent time. A new feature was added, apparently, which was a ring made of stone that was set in the walls on either side of the court. The ring was mounted vertically, unlike the basketball hoop, which, of course, is horizontal. As far as we know, none of the games that we play today, including basketball, is a direct descendant of this ancient game.
But basketball is a direct descendant of this game, Duck on the Rock. As the game's founder, Dr. James Naismith writes,
"It was Duck on the Rock that was later to play such an important part in the origin of basketball."
Duck on the Rock's elevated target and arching shots were elements Naismith needed to invent a cold weather indoor finesse game for rambunctious ruggers and footballers here at the YMCA Training School in Springfield, Massachusetts, where he taught. Since Naismith hung his peach baskets and the original 13 rules in that Y gym, basketball has been highballing through generations, embraced by sportsmen and women of kaleidoscope variety. Join me now, 100 years later, as we see Dr. Naismith in this rare and exclusive discovery, actual footage of basketball's original big man. Thanks, Dr. Naismith. Thanks a lot.
And we second that. As you heard John Saunders point out, he was very quick to point out that Dr. James Naismith was a Canadian, but I bet John didn't know that he was from Benny's Corners, Ontario. Duck on a Rock, a Canadian game, in case you're wondering what that was all about. I hadn't heard about that, trying to put the little rock on top of the big rock. I guess that's where Dick Vitale gets that expression, shoot the rock. When we come back, some more scores on this college basketball halftime report. Kansas State has swiped the momentum from Kansas. They have a 4-point lead. ESPN's presentation of NCAA basketball, Kansas versus Kansas State, is brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? And by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light.
Welcome back once again to the Bramlage Coliseum on the campus of Kansas State University in Manhattan, Kansas at halftime. A 4-point game in the 220th meeting of these two clubs. Kansas State, the home team, looking for their first win in the conference, up 30-26. John Saunders along with Larry Connolly. And Larry, this is a game that it really hasn't been a classically played game as far as up in the 40s and points and such, but it's been extremely exciting. And one guy, a guy you talked about with me beforehand, has been one of the main reasons.
Oh, I think Wayne Jamison just had a great basketball game this first half. And not only has he done it offensively, but he's done a little bit of everything. He's rebounded. He's come up with some loose balls. Let's take a look at some of the play right now that you're going to see from this first half. And I think a lot of it has to do with just his attitude about the way he plays. Alonzo Jamison with a great move right there, faked one way and went the other. And while he had a good first half for Kansas, Alonzo did, take a look at some of the play on the other end for Kansas State. Delaware, who needed to get out of the gate quickly, did in the first half. He's had two bad games in a row. He had a great first half. He had 10. But here's the play, not only of the night, but maybe of the season. Watch Jeff Wires go up and simply just strip the ball right away. What a play. What an unbelievable play.
And then he was afraid he had the foul called against him. You see the reaction there. Take a look at the halftime stats. Pretty close in the field goal percentage. Free throws, neither team really that well. Although the Cats 6 of 9. Rebounds.
five more in the favor of the Jayhawks, but the turnovers, obviously a telling stat.
Well, it also tells you that both clubs are playing pretty good defense. The three-point field goals, neither club has been able to convert on those. They're 0-9. Here's the storyline right now. Kansas, Brown only has 2 points. He's 0-3 from three-point range. He's really their Trey shooter. Jamison with 12 points and 6 rebounds. 10's his career high. Kansas State, Delaware, 12 points, 5 of 9 field goals. 14 of 30 points off of those turnovers.
And for Roy Williams, Maddox and Randall, a couple of his starters, have combined to only attempt 4 shots in the game and make just one of them.
Jayhawks really picked it up in the latter part of the first half. Kansas State misses the first one. Good strong rebound by Wires.
Keeping it alive was Britton, and Amerson comes away with it.
Delaware down the middle.
No good. Amerson, though, gets the easy dish off the glass.
John, I got to tell you a quote Dana Altman gave me today at breakfast. He says, if this game is pretty tonight, we don't have a chance. Well, it's not pretty.
Nice job by Randall to lean to the hole.
Randall only his second field goal. He and Maddox were only 1 of 4 in the first half. Unbelievable. Here's the kind of defense Kansas State was playing to keep the ball out of the middle. Kansas has such a high percentage of shooting, but a lot of those are shots down inside off of great passes. Kansas State does not allow that ball to go to the inside.
Delaware from the baseline, it won't go. Maddox comes away with a rebound. Randall on the run converts.
Yeah, all of a sudden somebody left a wake-up call for Mark Randall. He's alive now, 2 for 2 in the second half. Here comes a trap.
Nice strip by Jordan, but it was kicked out of bounds by his teammate Maddox. Jayhawks 13-1 when leading at halftime, and they have yet to win one behind at halftime. So a couple of goose eggs they're trying to break here. That's when they're behind and also get a first road win and also get a win when Larry Connolly does their games. They're 0-2.
You haven't lost with them, and I haven't won with them.
That's right. I'm 2-0, you're 0-2. And of course, for the road win, I meant in the conference in the Big 8. They have yet to pick up the victory.
A little less pressure this half by Kansas. They're backing off. Delaware trying to take advantage of good help by Randall.
Delaware looks away, then puts the shot up. Amerson almost gets it. Delaware shouldn't have put it on the floor. And when he does, the shorter player, Adonis Jordan, takes it away.
And then a change of defense. Now Ziegler's going to guard Terry Brown. Now they switch wires. Oh, they left
Jordan. Jordan was alone, and Jamison found him. Jamison's limping back up the floor, though.
Miscommunication that time by Ziegler and by Wires. They tried to make a switch, and they forgot about Jordan.
Watch Jamison. He's hurt. Nice rejection by Randall as Amerson tried to take it in. Richie will check into the game. I think Jamison will come back out. And as you watch him leave, you can see visibly that he has a limp.
His left ankle or his left knee.
Trainer over to give it a look.
Myers wants to take Jordan one-on-one. Good fake.
Puts Jordan in the air and gets the shot.
Good finish. Jeff Wires. Good start to the second half for the Rock. Kansas loves this passing game. Screen away. Screen toward the ball, look to the inside.
Maddox gets it, and over top of his back is Wiley Howard. Not a good move.
Yeah, you always got to ask why. I mean, why does a guy who's on the backside of a player want to reach around and try to get the ball? There's no way you're going to get it, and you know the official's going to make the call 9 out of 10 times. Wiley, listen to what John and I are telling you.
That drives coaches crazy, and that'll get you a ticket back to the bench in a hurry.
Game.
Randall back over Brown, and reaching in is Jeff Wires, and that will always get the foul called as well.
Now, Wires has done such an excellent job. It's his second foul tonight on Brown. He's so quick with his hands and his feet, it's very difficult to ascertain when he does foul because he is so quick. These clubs play the zone defense except for the half-court trap by Kansas. It's been nothing but line up toe-to-toe. nose to nose, and get after each other.
The foul on the floor, and Wires picks up a second quick one. That's his third. I'm not surprised that Kansas State hasn't played a zone. And you have Terry Brown, the way he can shoot the three-pointer, but on the other hand, maybe. Jeff Wires, foul means trouble. A 4-plus, 0-for-4. When he has less than 4 in a game, the Wildcats usually win.
Well, the guy who leads the club in assists and steals. He had 11 assists against Lamar.
There's Brown with that unorthodox three-pointer. Takes the ball way behind his head and lets it fly. That's tough to block.
Hey, it didn't have to be a Renoir. It just has to go in.
That's right. The game has swung to the Jayhawks. They lead by one on that three-pointer. Maddox turning around is fouled. Oh, they call the travel. Trying to turn to face the basket. He didn't have a pivot foot.
John, I'm beginning to wonder if the effort that Kansas State put forth defensively in that first half might not have drained them. I mean, they really did get after Kansas as hard as I've seen any team this year defensively. And I'm wondering if it might, if Dana Altman's club might have been drained a little bit. They say they look like they're a little gassed to start the second half.
I don't think there's any question, and they did do a tremendous job, especially on Brown.
Good skip pass.
Ziegler off the mark. Nice job on the boards, though, by K-State. Wires fakes the shot, gets closer, and gets it.
Wires with a nice little fake. Passed up the shot, got 3 feet closer. The dump down inside, Randall. He's hot, he's back.
Mark Randall has regained the touch he did not have, didn't even attempt that many shots in the first half.
He's reached his comfort level. He sees Maddox out top feeding him.
Jordan had a hand on it, that's why they didn't call the over and back. Wires taking it to the hole.
A dangerous play. It could have been his fourth. It goes the other way, and the fourth foul is levied on Mark Randall.
Someone was going to get their fourth on that play. Very dangerous. The charge could have been called.
Here's the play. That's a big one. Randall with the move in. Wires with the basket.
I'll tell you what. That was one they could have called either way. Wires converts it and puts the Cats back on top by two. 39-37, 15-30 to go in the crowd on its feet. Congratulations to Eric Murdoch. Had a chance to see him firsthand last week. Quite a player. Probably played himself into an NBA player. Here's another guy who the NBA scouts like, but he's on the bench right now after picking up his fourth foul with well over 15 minutes to go.
And John, what makes that tough is he started out so strong the second half. You know, he came out, got three baskets right for Kansas and got him that lead, and now all of a sudden he's going to have to sit over there for about maybe 8, 10, 12 minutes.
Steve Fritz picking up his fourth foul as well. Not as crucial, obviously, for Kansas State as Mark Randall is going to the bench for Kansas. Brown comes around the screen of Jamison and has the three-pointer.
Well, what he didn't do in the first half, he's making up for in the second. A couple of big ones. Terry Brown, downtown.
8 points now after having just two in the first half. Ziegler, nice, tries to push it into Britton.
I always like the way Brown shoots his threes. I mean, he launches them. I mean, you're talking about way behind his head, way up in the air.
You see the field goals by half in the second half. Kansas, 6-for-6. Still with the lead, 1 point lead for the Jayhawks right now.
Jordan trying to keep up with Wires out top. It's a great matchup. Terry Brown on the other side trying to keep up with Ziegler.
Delaware on the baseline, too hard with the shot, and Tunstall comes away with a rebound.
Tunstall with good defense.
Nice pass. Jamison can't get the shot to roll in. Did a nice job protecting the basketball and getting Britton to foul him.
Jamison went to the bench with a bad ankle just a few minutes ago. It didn't look like he was showing any ill effects of that ankle going down that lane. It's amazing how those injuries disappear when you got a basket in sight. Watch it again. Donis Jordan running the floor. Watch this. Coming right into your living room. Look at this pass. Jamison looking ahead. You see that catch right there, John? That's what I'm talking about, the passing ability of this Kansas team. They never throw one over your head, never one at your knees. It's always right in the chest or right at head high so you can catch it and do something with it.
Jamison picking up his 13th point to go along with 7 rebounds on the night.
He's not wavering at all from his first half play. He's continuing right in the second half.
Gets the roll and has 14 in the game.
2-2-1 pressure by Kansas. Kansas State very quickly up the floor.
Delaware too hard off the glass.
You got to finish the play. That save by Jamison.
Nice job to hang on to the ball. That was out of bounds. Dunstall, long distance. Jamison. Nice job by Jamison. But has it stripped away, but there is Maddox to convert.
John, there are two plays by Jamison. The one we're going to show up in the boxes tomorrow. A save of an out of bounds play and a rebound. It kicks off in his hands.
Kansas State wants a timeout. They're down by 5 now after leading for most of this game. College Coliseum, a beautiful building, and just a couple of years ago, the Jayhawks' first visit in here, the 14th, 89, was a great one. Would go into overtime. Lakeith Humphrey hits this shot to send it into the extra period. And then Kansas State down by 1 with a chance to win the game. Time ticking away. They get a good shot but can't convert, and Kansas wins 75-74 in overtime. The Jayhawks are the only team in the Big 8 that has not lost here at Bramlage Coliseum. 3-point shot is no good, and Maddox comes away with a rebound.
John, a point I want to make in the second half. Kansas is beginning to beat Kansas State down the floor, which they did not do in the first half. Look at Jamison inside. No, it was not Jamison inside. Who was it that got that layup? That was Scott. Richard Scott that got it.
Richard Scott
off the
went
bench.
After the ball was tipped away on a block, and then Scott followed it.
What a great play by Scott underneath.
Delaware, though, from the baseline.
Now, let me finish that thought. They're beginning to beat Kansas State down the floor with their break. They were not able to do that in the first half. Maybe a sign that Kansas State might be tiring a little bit.
Defensive pressure is not what it once was, and in the air as Ziegler gets on the back of Adonis Jordan, and that's a foul.
Dana Altman's going to make a change right here. Looks like he's getting Rediger into the game. Also, Wiley Howard.
That's 4 on Ziegler, who's done a tremendous job handling the basketball for Kansas State. So with 13-12 to go, he's in some foul trouble as well. Pardon me, that's not 4 on Ziegler. That's just his first.
Patrick Ritchie had to come back over to the scorer's table. I'm not sure. Oh, he had to report?
Hadn't reported in, so they'll send him back. The official gets a good laugh at it. Roy Williams wants to know why.
That's the time.
Just in before the 5-second count.
K-State down the zone. Sort of a 3-2, packing it back inside. He's just going to open it up to the outside for 3-point shooting of Kansas.
A little bit of a matchup as they are bringing their man out to the basketball. It's Adonis Jordan, a 3-pointer.
You go to the zone, you could get burned.
If you are going to match up, you better make sure you're in the guy's face. 8-point Kansas lead.
Not a bad move, though. Good thinking now right there by Kansas State. They got Brown out of the lineup. Might as well take the chance.
Wires with a silly foul as he reaches in, slaps the hands of Scott. That is his 4th personal foul. So now Kansas State in the backcourt is in some trouble. That's also the 7th team foul. 12:35 to go. Time for another stats flash.
Right? Yeah, field goal percentage. Kansas has really picked it up. 73%. K-State's falling off 36, rebounding 7-4 in favor of Kansas. Look at the front court points. Kansas with 12, K-State with only 4. Our crack producer, Woody Fryman, came up with that little stats flash.
Kansas certainly in the driver's seat now with a 9-point lead. The Wildcats over the limit, only three away from having a two foul shots. And the Jayhawks, only one team foul in this half.
A little bit more pressure now by Kansas. Looks like a 1-2-2 trap. Kansas State's trying to push the ball up the floor, keep the ball in the middle against this press. Haven't heard too much from Delaware recently. He needs to get hot again to get him back in this game.
Anderson with nowhere to go. He's got no help. Finally, Rediger comes to his aid.
Well, Kansas defense has really been turned up a notch. Wayne Smart.
Wiley Howard with the ball with a couple players on him. And Tunstall finally is called for the foul. Only the second team foul again, so.
Roy Williams' club has really picked it up the second half. They're playing much better than they did in the first half. Shooting better, getting down the floor. The defense is considerably better.
Delaware is open and has the shot.
There he is. He needs to contribute a couple of baskets here, three or four. Now look at the Kansas club get down the floor quickly. Good pass
to Scott. Nice pass by Tunstall to Scott. Shot, though, is rejected. It still belongs to Kansas. Amerson wasn't going for the fake. Jamison comes back into the game. Richie will sit back down.
The club's having difficulty getting the ball in against the defenses on the out-of-bounds play. Pressure now. Kansas State seems to be turning the defense up just a little bit.
Scott had Maddox momentarily, decides to take the shot by himself.
Richard Scott, two buckets now in the second half.
Some good help off the bench by Richard Scott.
A freshman from Little Rock. Hand check, Terry Brown.
I want to remind everybody, still more great basketball comes your way here on ESPN this week. ACC Big East Wednesday this week. The number 5 team in the nation, St. John's, leading the Big East against the two big guys of Georgetown. They're ranked number 18. We'll follow that by moving to the ACC. Duke against Georgia Tech. All teams ranked in the top 25 on ACC Big East Wednesday.
Well, isn't that a great game with Georgia Tech and North Carolina the other day, Chapel Hill? Bobby Kremen's club really turned it on that second half.
Malcolm Mackey is having a good year for Bobby Kremen.
Look at Louis Carnesecca's club. Where are they playing well?
He's 5 feet away!
You might have heard that. Roy Williams let us hear it. He's 5 feet away.
Foul is on Kansas. Rediger will inbounds. Delaware.
Roy and Dana Altman both working the officials well tonight. It's a running commentary. That may be a walk or a push, either one.
They call the foul, I believe. Delaware trying to find his way to the hole and trying to cut into this 10-point lead for the Jayhawks.
Alonzo Jamison is the guy saddled with the responsibility for shutting down Delaware on the outside, but Jamison's done a pretty good job of pretty well containing him tonight. He got off to a fast start in the second half. He hasn't done a whole lot. There with Delaware.
Ziegler bounces it in, and a nice move by Wiley Howard to cut it back to 8.
One of the few times we've seen the ball go inside against the Kansas defense. K-State did a nice job. Good pass and good roll.
Brown is stripped. They'll call a foul on Delaware. Delaware thought he had everything but the hand of Brown.
Watch the move again. Gene Delaware right here. This is Kansas with the basketball. Now watch Brown move right here. Delaware from the backside.
Not much question there. Again, a couple more fouls with the new rule this year. It'll be 2-shot fouls the rest of the way for Kansas. And we're still over 10 minutes to go in the game. Gets the roll for his 9th point. 7 of those coming in this second half. Not but this time Redinger goes up for it, battles with his own man, and Kansas will retain possession.
Yeah, when things are going badly for you, they seem to go badly all the way around. K-State really battling hard for that basketball.
Britton will come back in as Redinger sits down. You see the scoring in a half. Kansas State had that four-point lead at halftime, but they've been outscored by 13 in this half.
They scored two more points in the second half than they did the entire first half, and we've got 10 and a half minutes left.
Brown, from behind the back again, gets hammered after he releases it. See if they say it was in the act of shooting. Close to it, not matters.
I think Wally Howard was far enough out there to block the shot. He could have bought a seat. He was down there so far.
Redinger comes back into the game, and sitting down this time is Wiley Howard.
That was a good one and one. It was after the shot. And these clubs just cannot make their free throws. Good clubs make free throws. You've got to have those ones they give to you free. Good look inside.
We go to Anderson. Nice job by Johansson to go in there. Johanning, rather, to block that.
Johanning got over there pretty quickly. Watch Jordan on the defense right here. Now watch Johanning come from the other side. Amerson's right there to take the shot. Johanning will have nothing to do with that.
Ziegler quickly off the inbounds pass, but it won't roll in for him.
Kansas continues to push the ball up the floor. Now they're looking to the middle.
James, nice job to change hands and roll it off the glass.
How about Richard Scott's pass? Kansas playing like the club has been playing the last four games. They've won four in a row. The half has been an outstanding half of them. They got the steal.
Another turnover. Jamerson gets it in the back. Jordan for three. Knocks it in. And the Jayhawks have their largest lead at 14, 59-45. And once again, we have a timeout. Dana Altman sees this one slipping away, wants to map something out, and the Jayhawks lead with 9:39 to go.
This is Dikembe Mutombo and Georgetown. Then Duke simply wrapped Georgia Tech in an early season clash. Now Kenny Anderson is ready for payback time. Wednesday night, live on ESPN.
Welcome back again. John Saunders along with Larry Conley here in Manhattan, Kansas. The Jayhawks lead is now 14 after they trailed by four at halftime. One of the big reasons, three-pointers. They didn't have any in the first half, 0 for 4, 4 for 6 in the second half. Adonis Jordan and Terry Brown have really turned it up. Both have a pair apiece in the second half.
John, the only way Kansas State's going to get back in this basketball game, offensively, they've got to begin to hit some threes, but look at the steal. Kansas already got it.
Jameson is having a whale of a game. Ziegler has to commit the foul. That's just his second, I believe. But Jameson has been doing everything tonight.
Well, he does everything for this club. I talked about it in the early part of the second half about what he does for this team. Not only his rebounding, his steals, everything that he does for the little things. But you got to contribute to be a good club. Look at this steal right here. Slap away. He says, I'm going to take it myself. I got a guard on my right. I'll go ahead and try to lay it in. Get back to my other thought about Kansas State getting back into this basketball game. They've got to have some offensive punch from guys inside and outside, but they've also got to turn this defense up a notch, much like they had in the first half. I talked about them being maybe out of wind, tired a little bit. I think maybe they are. They appear to be so, anyway.
Well, the ability to force the turnovers as they were doing so well. He's tied his career high with 10 rebounds. He'll likely go over that the way he's been playing. But their ability to force the turnovers to Wildcats has not been evident here in the second half. And that's why they're down.
And one of the problems is they've got Jeff Wires with four fouls, so he's going to be very careful. Don't get it back all at once, but make sure you get good shots.
Redinger pushes it back out. Wires leans in. Can't get the roll. Nice follow by Britton, and he's fouled.
That was an interesting foul. Richard Scott was on his backside on the floor, and he reached up and grabbed him as he started to release. Mo Britton to the line.
I was trying to figure out how he committed that foul when I saw the man they called for. My reminder, up next, Kentucky, ranked number 10 in the nation, and Auburn in the SEC. We're on Big 8 SEC Tuesday on ESPN.
Getting those guys a little early tonight, maybe, huh?
Maybe. Mo Britton struggling tonight, just 2 points in the game.
Timmy and Dan down there in SEC country?
Well, Timmy worked last night, so I believe he has the night off.
He deserves one. Kansas stays with that pressure. Now they're going to, Kansas is going to pick it up. I thought K-State may come out and pick him up full court. Kansas just looks it over. K-State now at midcourt. Myers is going to be very careful about picking up that foul. Doesn't want to go out of the game. They need him out front.
Brown thinks about it. Jamison finds an opening and pushes it out to Maddox. Nice pass by Jamison, bouncing it into Scott, who can't find the handle on it.
John, there's a little triangle game they got going right there. They had three guys in sort of a shape of a triangle, passing the ball between the three of them, and the last one was a beautiful bounce pass down inside. Kansas State got it, knocked it away.
Brown behind Scott's pick.
He shot that one from Roy Williams' lap.
Nice job by guess who to tip that ball away. Ed Hightower is going to overrule the original ruling and say that it belongs to Kansas State.
In for the Jayhawks, Patrick Ritchie, number 12.
Patrick Ritchie comes in for Kansas. Marcus Ziegler back in for Kansas State. Mo Britton's going to stay in. Jamison comes out.
That's a good idea. Give him a blow right now. He's had a pretty good second half.
Tunstall now comes back in as Terry Brown will sit down.
Oh, give me one. Only starter left on the floor for Kansas right now is Maddox.
Delaware in the paint.
That's a mismatch. You got Ritchie out front trying to guard Delaware, and there really is no way he can keep up. 6'4 against 6'8 out on the floor. Open court. Delaware's got the advantage. Kansas State turning the defense up a little bit. Ritchie's open.
Shot won't roll in. Kansas State can get it back under double figures in this trip. Mo Britton with a good catch. Back out to Delaware on the baseline. This tries to hang, and Ritchie gets called for the foul.
Well, two consecutive trips now. Patrick Ritchie, the defender, trying to stop Gene Delaware, the guy handling the basketball. Not sure I would make a little bit of a switch right there. I would get Ritchie off of him, put somebody else on Delaware. He's not going to be able to keep up with that guy. Watch Britton inside. Pass was a little bit too high for him to do anything with, so he gave it back to Delaware, who made the baseline cut. There's a little bump. Gotta leave those shooters alone.
Delaware knocks it in, and it's a 10-point lead. Jamison checks back in. And Ritchie will get a seat.
Let's see if Jamison goes back and guards Delaware in the next trip down the floor.
Wiley Howard will come in for Mo Britton for Kansas State.
Yeah, a little bit smaller lineup when they put Wiley Howard in there at 6'8". Kansas State going with a smaller lineup. I wonder if they're thinking about pressing right now, down 10.
7:33 to go. We're under double digits now.
No pressure yet. Crowd wants something done. They've been kind of quiet in the second half. The Jayhawks have taken them out of the game.
Good job of denying. Delaware almost comes up with the steal. They will call a foul on Wires.
Oh, Wires.
That's his fifth. The official hesitated as if he wasn't going to make the call. But when Wires went right under the player, there was no question and no doubt he had to blow the whistle.
That might have been the slowest fall I have ever seen. It was like a big tree just tumbling to the floor.
Dana Altman letting them have it as Jeff Wires has to go to the bench with 13 points, 6 rebounds.
Well, this really puts a lot of pressure on the rest of this Kansas State defense with him out of there. They can put that ball in the hands of Marcus Ziegler to handle it for the offensive end, but they've got to have somebody defensively out front to handle Terry Brown and Adonis Jordan.
You also on Thursday night, a triple header here on ESPN. We'll start it off in the Big Ten. The Ohio State Buckeyes, one of only two undefeated teams in the nation, and ranked number three at Michigan State. That is 7 o'clock Eastern. Then we'll move it to the ACC, where North Carolina Tar Heels, number nine, against a Clemson team that's struggling yet to win in the conference this year. And then we'll move to the WAC at midnight, Wyoming and Hawaii. Triple header here on ESPN.
That man, Alonzo Jamison, has been carrying his Kansas club tonight.
17 points for Alonzo Jamison. That one was way short. The officials will confer on this one. There was a big chase for the ball. Maddox looked like he may have touched it last, but there were two K-State players there. And so the call goes towards Kansas.
Well, I'll tell you one thing, we couldn't see it.
No.
He had the whole bench up in front of us.
Mark Randall back into the game with four fouls.
Kansas State really needs to turn the pressure loose. You got 7 minutes left to play. You got to reach down and really play hard for 7 minutes.
That is a charge, no question. Nice job by Gene Delaware to step in there and take the charge.
And a good call. Watch Delaware number 20 get the position. Jamison there. A little bit of an acting job, though. It's okay. It's part of the game.
Nice job to come off his man, Jamison, and still get in position to take the charge.
Yeah, it was good help.
It's a 10-point game and plenty of time left. Just under 7 minutes.
And that man, Delaware. Jamison on him.
Thrown away by Jamison, picked off by Jordan. Nice dish to Randall, who gets the easy two.
Unselfish club. What a play. Jordan got it inside to Randall, and he laid it in. Very unselfish team, this Kansas club.
Jamison looking for help. Pushes it down. Nice turnaround by Wiley Howard.
Now you got to take advantage of that. If Randall's got four fouls, you got to go to Howard. If Howard's inside offensively against Randall.
Jordan spins, moves, and then leans back into Ziegler. And Ziegler gets called for the foul.
Let's go back and watch the big man run down the middle of the floor. Look at the steal right there. Good play. Now watch Randall in the middle of the floor right here. Jordan's got it, little dish. Randall says, nobody's in front of me, I'll take it.
Donis Jordan with 11 points. Puts the lead back up to 11 with that free throw.
Jordan's had a good second half. He only had two in the first half.
Gets the roll. Randall is hurt. As he and Howard were banging together, Eddie Hightower looked like he wanted to bring them together to talk about it. Randall went to the floor. Here's
watch the
look.
Left part of your screen right here. Howard with a good block out right there. He just got Randall on his back and they both went to the floor. Nothing wrong with that. That was okay. Good screen out, I thought, by Howard. Mark Randall just trying to get along. I think maybe he got upset because he fell on his foot.
He has to go to the bench again with the injury.
Right,
but
here's that 1-3-1 trap again by the Jayhawks. Kansas State tries to keep the ball in the middle. Good dish. Good pass.
Nice pass by Delaware. Wiley Howard converts it.
Kansas zone defense may be a little too spread. It's a little bit open. Need to pack it back a little bit.
Jamison with a little hook move gets away with it and gets the two.
He's Strong move inside. Jameson's done everything. Inside, the rebounding, the slapaways, the steals.
Delaware's shot is short, and Maddox has the rebound.
The screen out by that time by Mike Maddox. Oh, Kansas doing all the fundamental things now, going down the stretch to help you win ball games. I'm starting to think about running a little bit of clock now. Got a 12-point lead. They don't want to be in any kind of hurry. They are running clock. They're going to take their time. The half-court game, the passing game. Move the basketball. Don't let it stick, and watch the five-second count.
Johanning tries to pick up the pass. Amerson will be called for reaching in. He thought he had the clear steal. That's four on Amerson as Mark Randall gets ready to check back into the game. Apparently he's okay. Richie will come in as well.
Patrick Richie returns for KU.
I think Randall's foot's really bothering him.
Yeah, he's right in front of us, and you can see that he's working it back and forth, trying to stretch it, but clearly looks like he's still in pain.
This student body at Kansas State, except for timeouts, has been on their feet the entire ball game.
Mark Randall is trying to get back to his feet. But you're right, the Kansas State crowd is as vocal as you will find in college basketball. Well, Manning can't get the second one. Nice job by Maddox to push it back out, but it goes out of bounds and still belongs to Kansas State. Randall comes back into the game, and Joe Hanning will come out.
Coaches right there say contain, contain. Let me take the pressure off a little bit and just play a little containment defense right here. Just keep your man away from the basket.
Wiley Howard can't get it, but follows his shot, gets his own rebound. That one's no good. Randall battling for it and comes up with it.
One of the problems they have right now, they'd love to go out and press, but they're missing their best defender in Jeff Wires.
Tunstall had the shot, but can't convert it. Marlon Shad leans, and the blocking foul is called.
What makes that significant right now, John, is the fact that that would be the ninth foul on Kansas, which would put Kansas State into the two-shot category, because the next one will be the 10th. Already, Kansas State's there.
Steve Fritz coming back in for Kansas State.
Come on!
Well, I think you can hear that. Roy Williams trying to cheer his troops on, or at least trying to get that last ounce. Dana Altman looks much calmer, down by 13. You'd think the reverse was the truth.
Well, I'll promise you this, that's not the calmest we've seen him tonight, but he has been up and down off that bench.
Marlon Shad, another one of many players for Kansas State from Florida. They seem to have a lot of ability to recruit players from Florida. And I'll tell you, with the snow here when I arrived today, I don't know how they do it.
Just a good basketball atmosphere. Well, they do love it out here. They turn out for these games.
Ziegler working on Woodbury.
Woodbury doing a nice job, just zigzagging back and forth.
Has it stripped, though, but Ziegler can't hang on to a nice steal, but then loses it out of bounds. We're under 4 minutes to go now. The Jayhawks lead is at 11 here in Manhattan. There's a look at Terry Brown, who struggled in the first half, as you can see, 0 for 3. In the second half, 2 for 3. And Larry Conley, this guy is simply owns the three-point strike.
You think he's been proficient? Look at this. He's actually got more than four teams in the Big Eight. Now you got to remember Colorado and Oklahoma are 1 and 2, Oklahoma being number one, obviously, but he actually has more three-point field goals than four teams in the Big Eight.
The record for a single season is 91, held by Mookie Blaylock, the former Sooner, now with the Nets.
Great pass. Look at Randall.
Maddox has it easily.
The press is there, but handling the press. Always look up. You find people open when there's a double team.
Fritz go. Three-pointer.
He shot that one from his navel.
Unorthodox release, but it goes. That's their first three-pointer of the game for K-State.
Randall, good, smart move right there. Experienced player, take it back out. Run some clock. On the road in Manhattan, just a couple hours down the road.
Tunstall off the mark, kept alive by Maddox. Nice job.
Get the possession. Possession's become crucial now. And he moves the basketball very well. This is where passing becomes so very important. Find the open man. Deliver the ball to him when he's open. Don't wait till the defense recovers. Richie, the freshman, out top.
Woodbury with Ziegler on him. Ziegler gives him some room. Shot clock approaching 10 and now under 10. Tunstall along the baseline and scores.
To perfection. That's the way you run the game. Oh, what a great second half these Jayhawks have had.
Shad can't get the roll. Gets it back. Amerson is wide open. Shot's no good, though.
Interesting. Roy Williams has got a couple of freshmen out here at the end of the game taking care of the basketball. Woodbury and Ritchie. A lot of confidence in these young men.
They're doing the job as well. Reaching his call against Shad as Woodbury was about to blow right past him. Under 2 minutes now to go. 12-point lead for the Jayhawks, looking for their first conference road win and looking to keep alive a seven-game and move to eight-game streak here in Manhattan. Take a look at the standings in the Big Eight. Missouri on top at 4-1. No tournament action for the Missouri Tigers on probation. But Nebraska, the surprising team. Oklahoma coming off a loss at home to Nebraska.
How about Oklahoma State, the Cowboys, and Eddie Sundander playing very well.
Got his son Sean running the court, running the floor at point guard, former Kentucky guard.
He's also got a great player by the name of Byron Houston.
Yes.
Remember that name, a player. Big Eight every year, blessed with good talent. This is no exception. A lot of people thought the Big Eight would be down somewhat from last year. I mean, they did have three clubs in the league that at one time were ranked number one in the country last year.
Yep.
And it has dropped off somewhat, but there's a little bit more balance in the league this year. Nebraska's got great talent. Colorado beat them the other night. Kansas club starting to play real well. Oklahoma State's right there. And don't ever count Oklahoma and Missouri out.
With the exception of the Big West, I think we're seeing the parity all across the country. Shot from the corner by Ziegler is a three-pointer. You see Seton Hall leading Providence.
Jordan's giving the whirling motion with the finger in the air, meaning run the offense, move the ball, keep rotating.
Morris Britton is called for the foul on Jamison. The lead is at 10. Just a minute 23 to go, but certainly stranger things have happened.
Well, SEC matchup later on, right after us. And Larrabee. Dan Bonner leading down there, Lexington, Kentucky, Auburn.
20 points for Jamison now. Just averages 10 a game, so he's had a terrific game with junior college transfer. That one's way short. He seems to be about 1-for-2 up there. I think that's his average at about 50%. Amerson falling away. The shot won't go. Nice follow by Britton. And a timeout. 107 to go. The lead is now down to 9. Back to Manhattan in a moment. Welcome back once again. 73-64 is the lead. The Kansas Jayhawks looking to keep their streak alive in Manhattan. Still a minute 7 left. Here's a look at that 1,300 points, 600 rebound club. Mark Randall joining the club today. Boy, I'm telling you, I wouldn't mind hanging out with some of those guys.
What a group.
It's a good group of company.
You got to remember, Wilt left, too. He didn't stay around.
That's right.
What a bad player.
No foul call. But still, Kansas able to beat the pressure. Under a minute to go now.
Stay spread and make your free throws.
Finally, Britton in the corner gets called for a foul to stop the clock.
Now, John, this was a basketball team that lost a lot of players last year. Kevin Pritchard, the great little guard that they had, Callaway, Jeff Gellner, Pekka Markkanen, who went back to Finland, decided not to come back this year. Freeman West, everybody thought Roy Williams' club was going to be down this year, but they're not. They're playing very well.
He's done a terrific job since coming over from North Carolina. And this team, as you said, was ranked number one for a good part of the year last year. Knocked off UNLV, the defending, or rather the team that would eventually become the national champion, did that in the NIT. Coming up next, Kentucky at Auburn. Number 10, Rick Pitino.
That game is down on the plains. Well, this Kansas State club probably is happy to get home. You know, five of their last seven games have been on the road. Got a few. I think this is the first of a four-game stretch where they're at home. They need to play a few games at their own friendly arena.
They hate to go to 0-5 in the conference, though. Drop to 10-8 overall. 50 seconds to go now.
There's just a strong surge in the second half by Kansas that really put this away.
And you look at Adonis Jordan, you think that this was still the first half the way the defensive pressure is. Nice follow by a couple of players. Amerson was there. Britton was there. Nice job by Jordan Stock. He almost ran completely into Delaware. Put on the brakes before he would draw the charge. And finally, we get a smile out of Coach Roy Williams.
That stayed a little tense. Best staff there, Jerry Green, Steve Robinson, Kevin Stallings, Mark Turgeon. Dane Allman's got some great guys on his staff, too. Jim Kerwin, Ken Turner, Greg Grinzing.
Amerson will lead the game. Ten points and six rebounds as he leads. Kansas State, next three games all at home. Colorado, much improved this year. Oklahoma, you'll see that on ESPN. Next Tuesday night, and then Iowa State somewhere in there hoping to pick up their first Big Eight victory of the year. About to drop to 0-5 now.
And the one thing Roy Williams is going to be pleased with is the fact that he's walking away with a win in the Big Eight, away from home now, but he's still not shooting free throws well. His club just cannot convert.
Tell you what, they better start shooting them better down the stretch if they want to contend. Top of long. Three-pointer by Marlon Shad. Just the excitement out of the distance on it. Jordan will pull it out now. Tunstall says, why not take the two? I've got the lane. And the Kansas Jayhawks will leave Manhattan with the victory for the eighth consecutive time. 78-69 is the final. Larry Connolly, I'm John Saunders. Thanks for joining us here. Let's go back to the studio and join Chris Fowler before the SEC. Chris.
Okay, John and Larry, thank you very much. Eight straight wins in Manhattan for the Jayhawks. They move to 3-2 in the conference. K-State 0-5, still hasn't won a ball game. Kansas, one of only two teams to win a game on the road in the Big Eight. We're set now to go to the plains of Auburn.